Let's down.
Three, two, one.
Hello, well, this is sportscaster Tim Joyce and Brendan Carson. Coming to you live from
Brendan's Facebook. I thought I was being brought on for Hidden Gems, but I guess I'm a sportscaster.
Ah, yes. Hidden Gems.
This is the first episode of Hidden Gems, spelt with a J, for no reason. Oh. Other than the fact that there already is a Hidden Gems, spelt with a G.
We've gotta make ourselves different.
Absolutely.
Set ourselves away from the pack.
Yes. So the purpose of this, well, there really is no purpose, but we're gonna make these on a very irregular basis, and the purpose is to find videos on YouTube under 10,000 views that are either complete garbage or hidden gems. That in the fact that they may actually be good, but we tend to drift towards the complete garbage videos. Hence the J and Gems. We unironically have a green screen behind us. That was supposed to cover the entire backdrop, but it does not, so we decided to leave it for...
The budget couldn't afford it.
Yes. Yeah.
It was slashes and the fucking conservatives ruined everything. Let me tell you.
Still watching by this point, I don't know why. This is going to be terrible. The videos are going to be terrible.
Yes.
Our reactions are going to be terrible.
Yes.
My dog might bark.
No. And... Don't let the dog bark.
Okay, the dog will
It will ruin this production.
The dog will not bark. I will occasionally promote beer like Caledon Hills, which is my favorite beer. And we will talk about nothing of substance or of value of any kind whatsoever. We hope to get zero views for the sake of our careers.
Perfect.
And we hope to make $0 out of pure shame.
We don't deserve even pity money. But...
So we have,
coming soon is a Patreon near you.
So we have six videos queued up. Timmy found three and I found three. They're all either good or terrible. We don't know what we've picked or what the other one's picked.
Hopefully for the latter.
We prefer terrible videos, but we hope you enjoy, and I hope you enjoy our reactions to these terrible videos and or hidden gems spelt with a J. So this first video, oh, that's our logo. It's very nice. I made that in Microsoft Paint. Our first video is called.
So this is the washed up soft toy dissection.
Yes.
So what you see here is a beautiful dog managed to find this lovely toy. Maybe you have a toy like this of your own. Who knows? But what we'll see is a very strategic form of dissection here. He wastes no time.
Don't ruin it for me. I have not seen this video
okay,
yet. So
okay.
So don't ruin this for me.
Let's go ahead with this.
All right,
let's do it.
Okay.
Giddy. Oh my goodness. What's that?
It's a very dirty toy.
Just rips it off. Look at that.
There goes the collar.
Just no problem. Gone. Okay. Fuck his ear.
What was that? That was
fuck
a fucking,
his nose.
No, that was an arm. That was an
that
arm.
Was an arm.
That was an arm.
Oh. And then he opens it right up.
His stomach.
Gone.
Oh, this
gone.
Is terrifying.
Gone.
That dog is efficient.
Yeah, the guy wastes no time, and there's no
Why
drugs.
Why is the cotton, like, brown?
So, you notice that? In the moment he realizes there's no drugs.
I do not want to watch a Microsoft Word tutorial.
The moment he realizes there's no drugs, he stops immediately.
That was...
Just want to bring that up.
Why was the stuffing so dirty?
Can't tell you.
That was almost as bad as our video blog so far.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
I give that a 2 out of 5. I would give it a 1 out of 5, but the dog was very efficient.
That's what I'm saying. He wastes no time. He got that collar off like that. He ripped the arm off. It looked like he just pulled it off like you're pulling a petal from a flower. Honestly, it was delicate
and efficient. It was very beautiful. Yeah, it was very beautiful.
I'm going to give it a little bit higher.
Okay.
I'm going to give it a 3 out of 5.
Ooh, that's very generous.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I think if the toy was a little bit cleaner, I would have given it better marks.
Okay.
Okay.
So our next video here is called Space Dribbles.
Yes. Give me the context.
There is no context. Unlike you, I didn't watch the video first.
Oh.
I just searched Space Dribbles, and this is literally what came up.
Okay.
So,
I'm ready
I don't know
for
what
this.
To expect.
My body is ready.
Okay. Here comes Space Dribbles.
I live for this.
Tales from Riverdale. She grabs some popcorn.
I hear the moon's made of green cheese. Yeah, everyone knows that. Let's go get
Turn
some.
It up.
It's worth a try.
No, yes! That was a great cut. That was a great cut.
Like,
the moment you hear
quality video editing.
And they're like bobbing to the music.
Why is there measuring tape? Oh, it was measuring tape. Is that a slide? Somebody slides down that. No. Yes.
According to my plans, we're gonna need.
I was loving the music.
Batteries.
Oh my god! You know what this reminds me of?
They're building a spaceship.
You know, you ever seen Jimmy Fallon? Real actors, fake hands. It's exactly like
yes,
that.
Yes.
Over a
yes.
Scene.
Yes.
And
you
I'll
need the couch.
What the fuck's going on?
Yo, he's making a spaceship. This is quality.
Yes, it's only a
here. Yeah, we can add that later.
Hanging over a muslin tree.
Okay, the second song I'm not about.
But it wouldn't be make believe.
Yes. Okay.
You
dot the I's, cross the T's.
Wait. His name's Chris.
Is it really?
Did you catch that? Yeah, the one Gerbil's name is Chris.
Chris is a slacker.
Do they know the legs are very crooked? I don't think.
Yo, how did they get in there? Did they get beamed up?
They use their space powers, man.
And there's the dog.
Oh, there's the dog. Yeah. I told you the dog was gonna work.
Oh my god.
Where'd the legs go?
And it floats.
With fishing line. That's fine. I'm pretty sure PETA's gonna have a problem with this.
No.
Whoa, they made it to space! Wow, I'm actually impressed. I didn't think that thing would get off the ground.
Beam me up, Scotty.
Is that an asteroid?
No, I think that's the moon. They landed on the moon.
Wow.
Yeah.
Legit, though. If that's like a paper mache moon, it's pretty impressive.
Just... They couldn't even get real gerbils! One small step for humans.
One large step for mankind.
You could
have at least tried to find a spacesuit for the gerbil. The head's killing me.
He's ripping apart the moon. Wait, are they
what's
harvesting?
SG? Well, one's in
space
Chris,
gerbils,
right?
Space gerbils, right? Yeah.
That looks like a very legit air tank. How is the air tank connected to the helmet, though? There doesn't appear to be an air tube.
Oh my god, I see what they made it out of. They made it out of the stuff you put underneath the...
Wow, that was amazing. They got out of their suit so fast. Sixth plate. Space Odyssey shit here.
Can you imagine if you left one of the gerbils behind?
Whoa, that was a hard landing for these poor guys. They seem to be okay, though.
Climb up. Infest the barbecue. No, okay, they're going into the home.
Doors open. Good security. Oh, I
climb
see
up. Fake hands climb up the tape. Yo.
It's like climbing in Skyrim.
I'm actually impressed by the person who videoed this.
The editing is good. The acting, I think, could use some work.
Yeah. They need better gerbils. I know a guy. He's been breeding gerbils for years. But
really?
We'll figure that out tomorrow night.
It was kind of like a Pinky in the Brain moment. So, what are we going to do tomorrow, Pinky?
Go to Mars, obviously.
Do what we do every day. Try to take over Mars.
Oh, is there credits?
Yes. The end. Okay, I hope we don't dox this person. Oh,
good job, Patrick and Jeff. Patrick and Chris and...
Oh, as the
this
human.
Very fast. Jen, Jeff, and Patrick, and Chris, and Emily, and
Paper
Michelle,
moons.
And Cliff, and... Louis Armstrong! Louis Armstrong gets
for the,
a credit
for
the song. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
That was... Oh, it is Louis.
I didn't know Louis Armstrong personally signed off for his song to be used in the making of this film. That's actually really impressive that these grade 8 students found a way to contact Louis Armstrong.
So, data entry form in Excel. So, what I have to say here, I'm going to give them a good 8.2 out of 10.
But now we're out of 10.
Well, dude, we gotta switch it up.
Okay, so now we're at a 10.
8.2 out of 10 for editing.
Yeah. No, you can't. You can't give multiple ratings. It's gonna be one rating. But you gotta justify it.
Don't take this away from me, man.
We have to stick to some kind of format on this terrible show.
Fine. I'm giving it 2 gerbils out of 5.
Now it's out of 5 again. Are we doing it out of 5 or out of 10?
Stop, mate. Dude, our format is made to be ruined. It's just like laws. They're made
okay,
to be broken.
So is it? Okay, you're doing 2 gerbils out of 5?
Yes.
Okay. I will give that 3 gerbils out of 5. The story was very good.
Yeah.
The editing was excellent. Yeah. I thought the acting was a little paper mache-y. Special effects, a little questionable. The space looked authentic, but flying the spaceship out of the house was a little iffy with the fishing line.
I think the human threw me off.
There was a human?
There was a human for a split second, and then they credited them. So it was.
They credited a lot of
it
was, they credited
no, no, no.
fucking Armstrong.
They credited someone for being a human in the video. So know what I'm saying? That human was intentional. We don't want that.
Okay.
I think
okay.
it ruined it. Okay. Creative choices right there.
Okay. So we're going to move on to the next video. Let's see. What do we have next? All right. We have... here we have...
So...
Lad... Oh, I don't have it pulled up yet. Hold on. So we have Lad Falls Off Gondola.
Okay. So I think this might be a little bit more common of a video than others, but I found it on a channel that just uploads.
You gotta stop giving context. I'm supposed to react to this video that you found.
I know. Okay, fine. We can just jump right into it. Jump right into it.
That's what the viewers are gonna want. They don't want to listen to us idiots talk.
I know, but sometimes you want to hear the story behind.
I'm not even sure I need a story. Just look at this idiot with the like knockoff Ray-Bans and his little gondola. I thought gondola was the thing that goes over the mountains to spend by the wire.
I think they're both a gondola.
Is that, okay.
Yeah.
This is a pagoda, not a gondola, I think, right? Isn't pagoda, or do I have that backwards?
No, I think you might be right.
Either way, the lad falls off something.
No,
and we're gonna
we'll
find
have
out.
The fact check coming in shortly after this video.
We're going to find out what the hell this lad falls off of.
We can't.
Maybe he's on the pagoda, if that's what this is, and then a dude just fucking falls off the gondola onto his boat.
Oh,
gonna,
man, that would
find
be,
out.
That would be sweet. Devastating.
Oh, they're not even moving.
Whoa.
How does he fall off the non-moving boat?
Whoa, wait for it. This is quality entertainment.
I like how he's got a Dixie cup in this boat. Oh, that guy fell off.
Gotcha.
Oh, man, we need an instant replay.
You can do it slower, too.
Oh, how do I do that?
Settings, speed.
Oh, speed.
And go 0.5. Let's do
0.25.
No, 0.25 is good. 0.25 is good. Now go to this spot. Oh, no, this is good.
Okay.
He sees it. You see the panic in his eye.
He sees the boat, so he's trying to, I guess, stop turning the boat?
Yeah. You see the panic in his eye.
But then floral shirt dude is like...
Oh, my God.
So rather than allow his boat to be hit, he would rather fall into his death.
It's true. You can tell this guy.
We know that guy died.
Yeah.
You can tell. He didn't come back up.
Okay. I'll give that 1 gerbil out of 5. That was pretty, pretty terrible video.
Doesn't even
that
deserve.
Was not exciting.
No. But
I feel like I could. I don't think it's worth 0 because there's definitely worse
no,
videos
I was giving
out there.
No, I was giving it 0.5 gerbils.
0.5
like,
gerbil.
If you took
okay.
the tail. 2 of the forearms or legs.
Yeah.
And maybe a couple organs.
Okay.
Made it together. You got yourself a 0.5 gerbil.
0.5 gerbil. I give it a 1 gerbil. It was pretty bad.
Yeah.
It's one of the worst videos I've ever seen. It wasn't funny.
But it
the
was.
The dude just fell off a boat.
It was only 17 seconds. So you didn't lose that much of your life.
That's what she said. Okay.
It's true. So.
All right. Our next video.
I'm sure she's used to it by now.
Our next video is a Pokemon fan fiction I found with 63 views.
Alpha.
And I don't know if I'm ready for this, to be honest. And okay. I'm also very worried about what my like recommended search results are going to be after this. But
quality. That's what it's going to be. It's going to be nothing but good news. But you'll notice here, you're going to need to turn up the volume. Because I think there's talking last.
I mean, I watched this for like 10 seconds and decided it was probably good enough for this Hidden Gems show.
Okay, let's do it.
If we can get through this whole thing, I'll be very impressed.
All right. If my eyes don't start
Pokemon
bleeding.
Fan fiction, Alpha and Omega, Episode 2, Viridian City. We didn't watch episode one.
Wait, there's an episode
oh,
one?
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, apparently. We're not watching episode one. Just gotta go in right into
the Pokemon
did
Company.
Did they get, like, permission of...
I don't think they did.
I highly doubt it.
But...
End game free.
As long
pretty
as...
Pretty sure this is copyright infringement.
At every sense. But as long as they don't make money, it's all good, right?
What is Pokemon? That's dice and Photoshop.
Hey, Lana.
Meridian City. It's a small city located in western Kanto. It is also known as the City of Evergreen for its lush evergreen trees that surround it on three of its four borders. Three major roads
three
lead from the
four
city.
Borders.
To the south is Route 1, to the north is Route 2, and to the west is Route 22.
Thank you.
Break it down for us.
Is this a city here?
How many blocks are
hold
there?
On.
The Meridian City?
Yep. It's home to the only market in Pokemon Center for all the neighboring towns.
You said there was a gym here too.
Oh yeah, the Meridian City Earth Gym.
Let's go there. Right
is
away.
The quality literally bad?
Like, it must be.
Come on, open
yeah, we'll
up.
See now it goes back to it.
My foot.
Ah, my foot.
Shut up.
Of the famous Blue Earth Gym.
That's not very good.
Wait.
Friends.
The professor's
grandson? Not kid friendly. Mm-hmm. Nintendo would not approve.
Shut up. I'm trying to listen to this masterpiece.
I'm trying to commentate.
Well, the gym's locked.
It's what they pay
now
me.
Now what?
To the Pokemon Center!
Michael and Jack were surprised to see the lights off at the Pokemon Center. The door opened just fine, but it was dark and there wasn't anybody, not even the nurse. Jack noticed some sounds
coming
from
behind
the counter.
How are they gonna heal Pokemon?
It sounded like two people were talking, but he couldn't quite make it out.
It's a ghost.
There was a loud crash and a Pokemon roared. Let's get out of here. Somebody yelled and a Tauros charged from the back room.
Where'd the Tauros come from?
Oh shit, are they fighting a Tauros now?
A man and a woman dressed in all black with a red R on their chest followed the Tauros out.
Who the heck are you?
Jack Alpha.
Well, Jack
excellent
Alpha,
voice actor.
You and your friend need to scram before you get hurt.
Why is she Russian?
No, don't you hurt me.
That's Team Rocket.
Team who? I don't care who they are. No one should steal from the Pokemon.
Your mistake. Go, Zubat.
Go, oh, not Zubat. Everyone knows Zubat
Michael,
is vicious.
I need your help.
Put out a squirrel.
Why is it all
are you growling at me?
I guess it was dark.
Unsure what to do. Everything in his body told him he needed to run, but he knew
true
he could not leave Jack here alone.
Dog?
Yeah.
Michael.
She wants in.
All right, Charmander, we need you.
If you guys want to see something more interesting
we'll
in this video, here's my dog.
Go first.
Oh, she's caught in the wire.
Let's hear some new moves.
This is Lana.
Both finishers nodded in unison.
Wait,
Squirtle's water gun hit Tauros, and Charmander's ember hit Zubat.
They ripped
however,
that right from
Pokemon,
Pokemon
phased it all.
Anime.
They did. They totally did.
That's all you got. Let me show you a real attack. Zubat, air cutter.
The attack hit both Charmander and Squirtle, knocking them off their feet.
Oh, no.
Charmander!
Before Tauros could attack, an Arcanine leaped over Jack and Michael's heads, landing in front of the Pokemon. Arcanine was huge and fierce. It stands with power. It stomped its foot on the ground, stopping the Tauros in its tracks.
Where did the Arcanine come from?
From behind, Michael and Jack could hear a mysterious voice.
Arcanine, roar!
Arcanine belted out a powerful roar, sending both Tauros and Zubat back to their Pokeballs.
Back into
quite a power.
Up, dropping their loot.
Arrest them, officer.
Police officers ran past Michael and Jack,
Gary
quickly
saved
arresting
the
Team Rocket members and taking them away. Turning around, Michael and Jack see none other than the Gym Leader Blue standing before them.
Gym Leader Blue.
Now let's go find the nurse to heal up your Pokemon.
Blue walked over to Charmander and Squirtle, picking them up, one in each arm.
Your boys, we need to have some word. What you two did was stupid. You and your Pokemon could have been hurt, or worse. But hey, I should say good job. You stalled him long enough for me to save the day. For that, I suppose I could give you a gift.
Blue throws a CD down on the table, gets up and walks away. He turns around and says,
"Hey, Jems here. They're chumps compared to me. If you can beat seven of them, come
it's
back."
It's very arrogant.
Michael and Jack sat in their seats quietly, waiting for the Pokemon to be healed. So they
oh,
can start the next part
oh.
of their journey.
Where did she come from?
A cast.
Yeah, man. Did you not? That's a production.
Good job, Michael.
So, I'm not gonna lie.
That was Michael, that was a great production.
That good would job, be a buddy. Better that would be a better book than it would be a screenplay.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
I've been waiting for that moment. I can't wait for part 3 or episode 3.
Yeah, neither can I, quite frankly. I think they could.
That could be next time.
The voice acting, I think, could use some work.
Yes.
It was real fuzzy there at points.
Yes.
Overall, the story was good. Still not sure where the Arcanine or whatever came from, but
No, it came in at the right time, though.
It did. Well, the Arcanine saved the day, and it made the gym leader guy look good, but
it made the Team Rocket look the Russian Team Rocket. Yeah,
why was she Russian? Dude, is Team Rocket Russian?
We're talking about we gotta create diversity here, man. We gotta get past our pale ass skin color that you and I are used to. And start looking at pale ass skin color.
I take strong offense to that. I am not pale.
That is Russian.
Okay.
Anyway,
this show's going downhill fast.
All right. I'm going to give that.
Oh yeah, we got to rate it. How many gerbils?
I will give that one gerbil.
Okay. Go ahead. You got an explanation?
They could get a little more gerbils out of me if the voice was a little bit better.
Okay.
And the quality of the pictures were nicer. That's all I asked for.
A little weirdly fuzzy there for a bit. I'll give that a 4 out of 5 gerbils.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
You're telling me this is better than that dog ripping apart that...
Yeah, I'm a sucker for effort. And I think Michael put a lot of effort into that.
So he was really how many gerbils did
about
you give?
This. How and about he the thought,
space
so...
gerbils?
Pardon?
How about the space gerbils? Did you not give the space gerbils?
I gave it one gerbil.
That was a lot of effort.
I think that was
more effort.
No, I gave the gondola guy one gerbil. Didn't I?
But
what did I get the space gerbils? 3, I think?
I don't even think you gave that.
Did we not rate that one?
We did, but I don't think you gave that much.
I don't remember.
Man.
But I still give the Pokemon 4 gerbils. Michael,
that's
good
gold.
Effort. I'm just most impressed that at some point in your life you made this video and you still don't regret it to this day, so you've left it on YouTube. Either that or you've forgotten your password. So if you're watching this,
how long
Michael,
ago was it made?
Please reset your password and maybe reconsider having that video online. But if you don't regret it, I need to see the sequel because I think there's a lot of potential there. If you can,
Hollywood's going to be contacting.
So I gave it a 4 out of 5, but that's mostly effort. So... the next video we have is called the Racoonegg's
Guide to Becoming a Devil Child.
16 Step Guide to Becoming a Devil Child.
It's only
15
seconds
long, and I am expecting nothing less than YouTube shit on this.
Perfect.
And then there's another page here at the end that I can't read because it's in some like weird fucking language. I'll try to translate as best as I can.
Quality.
Thank you, Tim.
I'm giving that meme worthiness 3 gerbils out of 5.
I give that 0 gerbils out of 5.
Like, man,
zero.
You're hating
zero
on my
gerbils.
Videos.
That does not deserve a gerbil. Not even half of a surgically reassembled gerbil. That was terrible.
The other half?
That was minimal
effort.
Think about
the other half. It was
minimal effort.
That is minimal effort. But
that was
this is borderline minimal effort.
Well, this is less than minimal effort. But we're not rating ourselves, thankfully. I would give myself -3 gerbils.
Wow.
That's fine.
That's really hard on yourself, man.
Fine.
I'm really scared for your mental conditioning.
Thank you. I appreciate that, but I assure you I'm okay.
All right.
Gerbils and no gerbils.
Well, I'm sorry about the gerbils.
Thank you.
That half gerbil.
My YouTube searches are going to be so fucked up now.
Yes.
Okay. We have one more video. This video is called Paul Offit, Let Me Love Your Child.
That sounds scary.
I have not watched this, so I'm going to warn you. I don't know what's in it. All I know is that I found it on an anti-vaxxer channel.
Oh,
so this is gonna be bad. This is gonna be real bad. But it has a lot of likes and not many dislikes. I'm not sure how many of those are ironic. I mean, some of the comments here. If I ever meet Offa, I will stick him in his arm several hundred flu vaccines and ask him if he liked that schedule. Okay, this is gonna be this may be in the lowest pits of hell. Let me poison and murder. Oh. Boy,
I mean, love
this
your
is
child.
Gonna be a lit video. Okay,
this is what
I have not seen a second of this. I just saw it. I'm like, that sounds appropriate for our show.
All right, let's see it.
All right,
get the fuck out of here.
Whoa,
passionate about
that was aggressive.
You know, let me love your child.
Often hear parents say it's about my rights, It's my parental right to raise my child as I see fit. But what about children's rights? I mean, who represents them?
Let me love your child.
If you're a child, it's assumed that your parents represent your best interests, and that's not always true. And when it's not true, as is true in this case, where parents have, say, a false belief that vaccines cause autism and they don't want to vaccinate their child, who do those children go to? And I think the answer is they go to the state. And I think that's what happened, frankly, in California, which used basically a child's rights issue as the central focus of how they made that change.
Let me love your child.
They wanted to see if they could get an interview with you, Paul.
Sean, let me love your child. They're trying to show this guy's a pedophile?
I'm just a camera guy.
No.
You're not interested?
Are you kidding me?
Well, just we could talk about, you know, differences in opinion, and
you know you can't do that here, right?
Get out of here. Get the fuck out of here. I don't want to talk to you.
All right. I mean, I just think if you have the truth on your side, you'd be up for just having a conversation.
You have the truth on your side.
Okay. I need to ask who you are. I'm just a camera guy, like I said. All right. Have a good lunch.
You need to be passionate about this. Let me love your child. Get the fuck out of here.
The guy just wants him to say that over and over again. Look at this horrible human being.
I know, right?
Who wants to
awful. He vaccinates children.
He wants to care just about your children. Monster. He cares about the health of your child. How fucking dare he?
Oh, hold on. Let's pause. Hold on. He instructed an audience of public health students to address parental vaccine safety concerns by passionately demanding them to love their children. What a
dangerous
fucking monster. Oh God. I can't.
How
okay,
dare
see
they?
How this ends. He's just, someone's got to arrest this guy.
I know. Oh, this is awful. You see Berkeley too. Oh man. Those libtards.
Awful school.
Those libtards. Let me tell you.
Nasty to be with them. Passionately refused. The makers of that documentary, which...
Is this the documentary? This quality piece of entertainment?
Was that it? That was the whole video?
Yes. It's just him wanting to love your child.
Oh, now I regret giving the raccoon one zero gerbils.
Yes, take it back.
Because I said I would reserve it for the worst video I saw, and that was undoubtedly worse. That was...
But he just wants to love your child. Think about it.
So hold on. Like, these people here are all, like, mad at this guy?
Yeah,
this man would be in the lowest pits of hell.
Because I think this is a an anti-vaxxing channel.
I know, but, like,
so the people who would
watch funny, ironic comments in here. Injecting my child with heavy metals and other toxins is not loving my child. It's loving Big Pharma's pockets, asshole. I like how she censored asshole. That was key. So she didn't get in trouble from the YouTube police.
Who represents this kid's right?
Yeah, right after they let me love you, you fucking psychopath piece of shit. That's aggressive.
So everybody...
Give your child a loving kiss of death. Oof, that's pretty metal. Off yourself, Paul. Ooh, got him there.
That's aggressive.
Paul, Lord. Which vaccine schedule are you on?
Lord have mercy on this man's
what?
Soul.
He's like accusing this guy of not being vaccinated himself? How are there so many of these people?
Dude, anti-vaxxers, they're passionate. They're
no
passionate
kidding.
About the fact that
because
they
I am vaccine.
You know what they want
damaged.
To do? They want to bring back measles. They want to bring back polio. They heard.
Oh, this makes me sick just
guys,
reading these comments.
What's greater than eradicating diseases?
I never felt any love when I was being injected by a sharp needle. Oh, here we go.
A true
Nazi unspeakable amount of damage to children, to families, ruining people's lives. What's his promotion of these poisonous... That is a run-on sentence, sir. Did you not take grade 12 English?
Most people who do drop out early. Regret.
People need to see that this short video and others where he makes it perfectly evident as a foremost authority of the only defense of vaccines, vaccine science, and legislation is empty, erroneous rhetoric, and blatant lies. What part of that video did you get that from?
Oh,
oh,
he not, has no, more!
I'm not reading the whole thing. No.
There we go.
Jesus Christ, I'm not reading the whole thing.
Okay. Man, there's a lot of people who are against loving children.
Ew, he shouldn't be 50 feet. These people all think he's a pedophile because he said, let me love your child. Look, I...
It's true.
Oh my God.
He must be. There's no other reason why he would say that.
Okay.
Can you think of another reason?
No. So, now we're going to do our bonus round. And our bonus round is we're going to take our highest rated video, which, what was our highest rated video?
I'm pretty sure it was the Space Gerbils.
Okay, so we're going to go to the Space... Where did the Space Gerbil go? Okay, so we're going to go to Space Gerbils, and we're going to click...
I think you might have closed it.
Did I? No, yeah. It's here. This is the Space Gerbils video.
Oh, it is.
I'm going to click the first related video. That's not recommended for me. I can't find anything else. Okay, well, let's just go to Space Gerbils, and I'll pick the second video. This is their bonus round. Oh, here. Space Gerbils Sacrifice. Okay. Oh. So, now, I have not even previewed this one. Tim has not previewed this one. We've just clicked it off of our favorite one of the Space Gerbils video. I'm very excited to see what the hell this is, though. Because it starts with Russia Today, and it's called Space Dribble Sacrifice.
I love how Russia Today has created content that has only 700 views.
I'm very excited.
They're like a very popular...
Russian scientist, NASA, ESA, analyzed the photon experiment. What has it got to do with gerbils? I don't know.
Please.
But we're going to find out.
Sacrifice them.
This is our last video of the of this terrible, terrible...
Play us out.
...video block. Okay.
12 days in zero gravity and they're back. A live cargo of mice, lizards,
so Russia Today has British newscasters
into orbit for scientific research.
Get out of here,
they were
tested
on board the Photon M3 capsule. You're not paying enough. How they react to space. Scientists are now studying the results. Our correspondent Anastasia Haidilina has more.
Just seconds after entering zero gravity, the
that's not a gerbil. Panic.
And then they started hugging each other. Five of
them spent 5 days
in Earth's orbit, and the scientists can now conclude they adjusted well to the experience. The Photon M3 capsule hosted 26 different experiments on various bacteria, bone cells, lizards, and gerbils.
Oh, there they are.
They all returned to Earth safe and sound last Wednesday.
Oh, wait. Scientists have gathered to collect were those signs? Were those signs on the field?
In northern Kazakhstan.
Where are the gerbils?
We're looking to find out if and how different living organisms survive in space.
Some the same way if every other organism does.
Could travel independently without a spacecraft.
Spoiler alert,
the European
they
Space
survive.
Agency placed a porous stone with living moss on the outside of the capsule to find out if it could survive through solar radiation and extreme temperatures. The Germans sent newborn fish into space. Canadians sent
they survived.
Cells and Russians,
that wasn't gerbils,
geckos,
though.
No, but that was tadpoles.
Oh, there they are.
But the research really began once they all reached their home laboratories around the globe.
Well, to find out how the animals are doing, we got here to the Institute of Microbiology.
How much are you hoping that this is like one of the reporter fails and she like hits the door?
Swing. Just runs into the glass.
Whoops.
Space gerbils won.
After the gerbils
Russian slash Russian reporter
Moscow,
zero.
They all were euthanized for further tests.
The first group of the results, which come from...
this is the most Russian dude I've ever seen. Vyacheslav Ilyin. Look at that mustache hair combo. He looks like Einstein, but not even close.
We were told in the world of science research there are no quick answers. Most experiments from Photon M3 capsule will take weeks and even months to be analyzed.
No, that dude, this dude right here. This dude.
Oh my god.
Is the most Russian looking dude I've ever seen.
But some Russian scientists already had something to share. Russian middle school students have also sent silkworms as part of their biology class curriculum. They'll be happy to find out their experiment resulted in space silk.
Unlike Earth silkworms, this one
that's
moves
a long
around
neck.
Thick, not around itself.
Holy shit.
You could explain it
I
by sheer disorientation.
I'm going to compete with him with a...
It's been
the
a century since humans comparison. Sent their first satellite into space.
Daddy Long Neck
I'm taking my throne back.
However, many species, including humans, on countless occasions have traveled beyond the Earth's orbit. But the scientists say photon satellites provide a unique platform for the experiments. Experiments that could change the way humans and the rest of life coexist in space. Anastasia Hedolina, Russia Today, Moscow.
So did you learn anything?
No. Yeah, other than Gerbils survived when they went to space and came back, I think.
When they put
that was a very disappointing bonus video. We'll have to do better for our next
episode
that
no one's gonna watch. It like salamanders that like latched on to one another? Like immediately upon going into like zero gravity?
Well, that's kind of what they showed. They had those like frog things or whatever at the beginning. And they
yeah, hugged. Yeah. I wouldn't hug. I don't need love.
I don't need love. Okay. that's it for the first episode of Hidden Gems. Pull up my shitty background here. Oh, where'd it go? Oh, I lost
no,
it.
Oh, there it is.
Okay. Hidden
Beautiful.
Gems. Hidden Gems.
Guys.
Thanks for watching. If you made this to the or if you made it all the way to the end, I feel very sorry for you. You sincerely need something better to do.
See you next week.
Yes.
Or the week after.
Yes.
Or the week after that.
This is Brendan and Tim signing off.
Toodles.
Ciao.